Hey, bonjour les amis. Episode 6 of me reading the bande dessinée called Le Secret des Templiers, The Secret of the Templars, featuring our hero, Jacques Le Gall, right here. Jacques Le Gall. Okay, so let's get started. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to read pretty slowly, and I'm going to repeat. But the translation is going to be very loose. Otherwise, it takes way too long. Okay, so first panel. C'est une liaison. Yeah. C'est une croix comme celle que portait sur le front. Mais Cagoulard. Ça alors, cette pierre doit pourtant dater de plusieurs siècles. So basically saying, so that's a cross like the one that the guys with the hood were wearing on their forehead. So this stone must be several centuries old. Siècle is century. So portait, imparfait. This present. Doit comes from devoir. Must. This stone must be blah blah blah. Alright, let's move on. Que peut-elle signifier? Ce paysan là-bas pourra peut-être me renseigner. So what can it mean? So elle refers to the cross. Hein? So this farmer over there. Will be able maybe to give me some info. So pourra is a future of pouvoir, to be able to. Can. Okay, let's move on. Cette croix, diable, je crois bien, c'est bien, and it should be je crois, okay. Je crois bien qu'elle a été plantée en souvenir de la prédication d'une croisade. Paraît qu'il y a eu un miracle. So this cross, I think that it was erected as a commemoration, for a crusade. So paraît que means hold on. I was supposed not to translate exactly, but let me get the. Okay, so this is present, huh? Present tense. So seems that there was a miracle. Paraître, seem. This is the third person singular. Present, indicative. Okay, so paraît. So this is there's a hat here, accent circonflexe. Paraît qu'il y a eu un miracle. Alright, next one. Une croix qui serait apparue dans le ciel, dans le vieux temps. C'est depuis qu'il y a une croix d'or sur l'écusson de Gisors. So serait apparue, so this is conditionnel passé. So this is être. So, qui serait apparu? And this is the participe passé of apparaître, to show up. So, across that that was supposed to have appeared in the sky in the old times, and since then there's a gold cross on the écusson is the écusson is the yeah hold on the shield it's the shield on the shield of Gisors. So Gisors is a city. So Jacques Le Gall, mais pourquoi cette forme? But why this shape? Why this shape? Pourquoi cette forme? Ok. Le notaire, chez qui j'ai travaillé, dit que c'était celle des Templiers. Dit que c'était celle des Templiers. Mais pourquoi n'iriez-vous pas le voir? Mais pourquoi n'iriez-vous pas le voir? Maître Perret à Gisors. Il en sait bien plus que moi. 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 So plus here is more. So the notary for which I was working said that it was the cross of the Templars. Why wouldn't you go see him? So Maître Perret in Gisors, he knows much more than I do. So here let's look at the tense. J'ai travaillé, passé composé. C'était imparfait. Iriez is the conditionnel of aller, to go. So this is the polite form. Hein? So it looks like second person plural. It's the polite form. Okay, so let's move on. Here we have a lot of text, as you can see. It's pretty common in bande dessinée sometimes. You get like a wall of text to explain things. And so that whoever is reading it learns something. Okay. Le père Lucas ne s'est pas trompé, jeune homme. So, le père Lucas, it's like a familiar way to address somebody, to talk about somebody. You say le père Lucas, la mère, blablabla. So, Lucas ne s'est pas trompé. So, this is passé composé. So, here you have what's called a form pronominal when you have se tromper. So, that's it's a pronominal verb. In English, un verbe pronominal in French, in English, it's a reflexive verb. So, in that case, in the passé composé, you always use être as the auxiliary. So, basically, Lucas ne s'est pas trompé. Se tromper, c'est to make a mistake. So, he didn't make a mistake. Young man. Ok, so c'est bien la croix du temple que vous avez vu à mi-chemin des ruines de Nofles et de Gisors. So Nofles is a city, Gisors is a city. It is indeed the Templar cross that you saw in between the ruins of Nofles and the ruins of Gisors. So here, vu, you put the I because le participe passé when using the passé composé agrees in gender and number with the complément d'objet direct if the COD, if the complément d'objet direct is placed before the verb. So in this case it's true because que is pronom relatif referring to antécédent la croix du temple and it's placed before the verb. So that's why you put a E here. Okay, so look it up in your grammar. The rules about agreement of the participe passé. Agreement of the participe passé when the auxiliary is avoir in the passé composé. I have videos about this too, so you can look it up. Oh, let's move on. Ce sont les Templiers qui ont bâti ces deux châteaux forts. Ils étaient maîtres de la région. So it is the Templars that built those two castles. They were the masters of the region. So on bâtit passé composé hein. Of bâtir, to build. Okay, so this is Maître Perret, by the way, the notary. It's not a lawyer, but it's kind of a lawyer, not quite. Okay, so now you have the last row, still a lot of text. On dit qu'ils établirent liaison. On dit qu'ils établirent leur plan de la forteresse de Gisors d'après la position des étoiles de la constellation du navire. Le 24 décembre 1090 à minuit. So, on dit qu'ils établirent leur plan de la forteresse de Gisors d'après la position des étoiles de la constellation du navire, le 24 décembre 1090 à minuit. À minuit. So basically, people say that they made their plans of the fortified castle of Gisors, looking at the position of the stars of the constellation of the or the star cluster of the navire, the ship. So the December 24th, 1090 at midnight. So it's a very loose translation. On prétend aussi qu'un souterrain de 4 km reliait jadis les donjons de Naufle et de Gisors, et qu'un trésor aussi fabuleux que magique y était caché. So, on prétend... So people say basically that there is a souterrain, a tunnel that's 4 kilometers long, like about 2.5 miles, something like that. Used to link in the old days. So jadis means in the old days, the two dungeons. And people say also. People say that a treasure as fabulous as magical was hidden there. So here this is the passive voice. Okay, so the tense is imparfait. So Jacques Le Gall, n'est-ce qu'une légende? N'est-ce qu'une légende? Isn't it only a legend? Ok, last one. Bien sûr, la fin tragique des Templiers a frappé les imaginations. Les bonnes gens d'ici soutiennent Mordicus, que les fantômes des Templiers, coiffés de cagoules, errent la nuit dans les ruines. Of course, so the tragic end of the Templars a frappé. So passé composé, frappé means hit. So hit. hit the imaginations. So les bonnes gens, the good people, the good people soutiennent Mordicus. Mordicus is something that's not used anymore. Mordicus. It means like stubborn, stubbornly. It's an adverb. Stubbornly. So the good people around here say that, insist that the ghost of the Templars, coiffé means like when you wear a hat, c'est une coiffe, coiffé. Oh, hold on. Covered. So the ghost of the Templars wearing hoods, air, so air is a wonder in the ruins during the night. So what? Okay, so I'm gonna stop here. This one was a tough one. So if you like this kind of comment, please like, comment, subscribe, and I'll make more. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Thank you. Bye.